Lessons learned on the Southern Pacific Siskiyou line.
And so he sees a train go by, not paying attention, and he goes, oh, there's my train. So he barrels out onto the main, only to find out he's facing another train coming at him.
On this edition of TrainMasters TV, bringing railroad memories to life with a bit of help.
I like to be the one to weather the cars, to lay the track, to do the modeling, but I am all about sharing with friends, and that's what operating sessions are all about. It's a time to get together with friends. That's when the layout really comes to life.
Regular maintenance keeps this railroad running smoothly.
I do have a policy. If we have a switch motor fail or a derailment at a certain point, I fix it the next day. I don't let problems accumulate. Most of our problems are engineers running red signals.
And 30 years of railroad modeling against the grain.
No one at the time had been doing Canadian stuff. So when I went to a club or to anybody else's layout, I had totally different equipment. And that was kind of like unique in the sense that I didn't have the same engine that you had.
Even in a small scale, model railroading has its limits.
If you had the biggest basketball arena in the world, I could design a railroad for it. But of course, you got to have time to build it. So I came up with what I thought would be practical, and I drew up the railroad.
And a railroad in the garage? It's not for the faint of heart.
When you have a winter like a couple of winters ago where temperature is negative 30, engines don't run as good on that kind of temperature. You know, I can't control that as much as I want to.
And big scenery in a small space.
I wanted to feel like I was walking down a riverbed and high rock walls just like it would have really been. I guess the only thing I didn't do right was I couldn't stretch the aisles out any wider than what I absolutely got them.
Take a tour of the west end of the Baltimore and Ohio.
I wanted to be able to walk down on a winter's day and feel like I had dropped into spring in West Virginia. And so I want the scene to evoke the emotions that I got when I was at that spot.
And 50 years at the Naptown and White River Model Railroad Club.
I don't look at this as my layout or our layout. I look at it as we are caretakers of the layout that was given to us.
And 20 years of enthusiasm for building a railroad designed for operation.
The more encouragement you get from building a railroad, the more you want to do. It's kind of like somebody says, wow, this is fantastic. And you look at them and say, you ain't seen nothing yet.